Hello, inquisitive entity. You're here because you are a curious creature like me. And today I'm going to be sharing with you four scientific findings about Afro hair. The information in this video comes from scholarly articles, my studies in trichology, books, and hair science symposia. Let's get into it. But first, please note that human hair is varied in many different ways, and researchers in South Africa have argued against the use of race in hair science, as it disregards people whose hair does not fall into the traditionally demarcated categories of European, Asian, and African. In this model, African hair typically means very tightly curled hair, while Asian hair is pin straight and European hair is straight to wavy. So this excludes some people of Asian and European heritage who have curly to very curly hair. And it also ignores the huge amount of variation in the degree of curl among people of African descent. And obviously there are lots of people groups missing as well. Let's not even mention the huge variation on the same head in terms of strand thickness, growth rate, and curl pattern. This video is going to focus on highly textured hair in people of African descent, and unfortunately not these people, even though some of the same things may apply. So what accounts for the shape of textured hair versus straight hair? It turns out that human hair shape is programmed from the follicle, and a follicle is basically a little house or a little tunnel in your scalp where the growing hair emerges. There are these cells that are rapidly dividing in these follicles, and as they divide, they push up the cells that are higher up, and then those eventually come out of your scalp and become your hair. These are biopsies of human scalps. You can imagine that a hole punch was used to kind of extract a little chunk of scalp, and there were follicles left in. If you look at panel A, you can see that the highly curly hair is emerging from a curled follicle. Compare that with panel G, where the follicle is completely straight and it's producing a straight hair. And in the middle, you can actually see an intermediate conformation. This person in the study is what in Trinidad would be referred to as a dogla, so somebody who is of African and Indian heritage, and they happen to have an intermediate hair texture. If we zoom in a little more closely, we can also see that the follicle exhibits what is called retrocurvature. Retro meaning back and curvature meaning curve. So the base of the follicle has a little curve in it. It curves a little bit backwards. And that only happens in hair with texture and not in straight hair. Essentially, a follicle is like a mold that gives your hair its shape. Because the opening that the rapidly dividing cells of your follicles are pushed through has a crescent shape, kind of like the moon, kinky hair is elliptical and not round as you would see in straighter textures. Here you can see how a texture fiber looks. There's a wide face and a narrow face. Contrastingly, this is what straighter fibers tend to look like. We love hair science, don't we? If you enjoy taking in videos about natural hair and the science of it, then you should take my healthy hair quiz below to find out how much you know about growing and nurturing long, healthy hair. Highly textured hair fibers are irregularly shaped. If you were to take coily hair and cut it into slices, you would observe slices of different shapes and sizes. This is an example of a kinky hair fiber, and you can see that its shape is not consistent. Rather, it has somewhat of a mountainous terrain. Here are some examples of what slices of your hair might look like under a microscope. Textured hair is naturally shinier than straighter hair, And this is because of its elliptical face, which allows light to be reflected very easily because of the flat faces on either side of the hair fiber. Healthy kinky hair reflects more light than healthy straight hair. Excluding buildup, there are two main causes of a lack of shine on natural hair. The first is cuticle damage. You can imagine that if your cuticles look like this, they're not so flat and so they're not able to reflect light as well as if the surface is smooth. This can lead to your hair having a dull appearance. Secondly, the other factor is whether your strands clump together. Because of the bi-directional structure of kinky hair, bi meaning two and directional coming from direction, a kinky hair fiber is basically bending in all kinds of directions, and so even though it might reflect light well, that light is going in multiple directions and so not creating the look of shine because it's being scattered. And it's also blocked by other hair fibers if there is no alignment between those hair fibers. Bearing this in mind, making your hair strands line up so that they're all doing the same thing can create the appearance of shine. And this is the best example I could find of my hair looking shiny. It's actually from 4 years ago. Did you learn something in this video? I am so curious to find out how much you know about growing long, healthy hair for the first time. Take the quiz that's linked below and on screen to find out your healthy hair IQ. My name is Asha, I'm a certified trichologist in training, and I help new and ambitious naturals grow long healthy hair for the first time through workshops and coaching.